This is R. Pooja from PG and Research Department of Mathematics, Idaya College for Women, Kumbakonam.
This video is dedicated to mathematician Mr. Srinivasa Ramanujan, FRS, Fellow of Royal Society of England. This National Mathematics Day, we celebrate his 133rd birth anniversary. December 22nd. This is his residence in Kumbakonam. He grew up in poverty, but he was rich in ideas. He brought glory to this humble town of Kumbakonam. This is his bronze statue in Town Higher Secondary School, Kumbakonam. Here he tutored senior students and questioned even teachers in complicated math theories. This is the Ramanujan Museum for Maths, Rayapuram, Chennai. It was this big city that propelled him to greater fame. This is Ramanujan at Trinity College, Cambridge University. He was one of the youngest members of Britain's Royal Society. Hey friends, this video, The Mini Mathematicians, is about maths in insects architecture. What maths do spiders teach us? To know that, let's look into its web construction. Spiders. First, a spider makes a bridge thread. It makes another thread too. Then it hangs from the second thread to form a Y shape. The Y shape with an angle of 120 degrees in between is claimed to be the most mechanically stable structure. It makes two anchor threads to keep the Y in place. A triangle, which is the most stable two-dimensional shape, is thus formed. Then it makes three corner frame threads to keep the triangle in place. Thus, three more triangles are formed. Then it lays out the radii of its spiral. It spins a non-sticky spiral to strengthen the framework. The spiral is not perfectly circular. Between the radial threads, it forms a curve called catenary. Finally, it spins a sticky spiral to catch its prey. The spiral shape adds to the elasticity of the web. That's all about it. Now, what maths do honeybees teach us? Why do they use the hexagonal design for the honeycomb cells? Honeybees. Bees consume 8 ounces of honey to produce 1 ounce of wax, which is their construction material. So, to use wax efficiently, they need a shape with maximum storage capacity and minimum wax consuming wall. That is, a shape with maximum area and minimum perimeter. Also, they need the cells to fuse together without interspaces. Let us consider condition 2. Which shape, when tiled, leaves no interspaces? Is it a pentagon? Or is it a septagon? Or is it an octagon? No, they leave interspaces. But what about triangle, square, and hexagon? They don't leave interspaces. Let us consider condition 1. Which of the following has the maximum area of any two-dimensional shape with the same perimeter? Let A denote the area and B denote the perimeter. The perimeter of a circle has a special name called circumference. We get the area of an equilateral triangle as 0.04811 p squared. We get the area of square as 0.0625 p squared. We get the area of hexagon as 0.07217 p squared. We get the area of circle as 0.07958 p squared. Circle has the maximum area, but when circular cells are packed, they leave interspaces. So, let's opt for the hexagonal design. The hexagonal cells don't leave interspaces. In reality, honeybees don't build hexagonal walls. They just build circular walls. The body heat of the bees melt the circular walls, transforming them into more stable hexagonal walls. The Y shape, as said before, is the most mechanically stable structure. That's all about it. What maths do ants teach us? How do they construct a living bridge? Ants. A leading ant freezes in the face of a gap. Its immediate trailing ant walks atop it. The second ant too freezes, allowing another to walk atop it. This process continues, creating a bridge of frozen ants. Ants link legs and mouths with one another. As the bridge gets longer, it needs to get wider. Ants maintain a steady ratio of length to width in their bridge. Actually, ants can't see. When the bridge is all done, other ants walk upon. The bridge is likely a catenary, which is a curve formed by a chain hanging freely under its own weight. The ants of the bridge sense the number of times they have been stepped on by other ants. When the number of steps hits a certain number, knowing too many other ants are occupied in the bridge, a frozen ant unfreezes and rejoins the march. When the bridge collapses, the ants of the bridge bunch together and survive. That's all about it. Similar to the insects, humans do use maths without realizing it. Wherever we go, whatever we do, we use maths. Let's decipher the mysteries of nature using maths. Thanks for watching.